नवोदय ग्रंथ प्रस्तुत करते हैं ऑनलाइन क्लास।
गुड मॉर्निंग डियर फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी शैल डिस्कस अ न्यू लेसन। द नेम ऑफ द लेसन इज हिज फर्स्ट फ्लाइट। एज यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ नेम हिज फर्स्ट फ्लाइट, इट मींस somebody who wanted to take the flight for the first time. Then who was that? Then this story is related to a young seagull. His first flight is related to a bird whose name is young seagull. Young seagull means this is a seabird. And now what happens? This boy had two brother and one sister and father and mother. It means we can say that totally 5 members were in his family. Then what happened? And all the family member were trying their best to teach him how to fly. As you can see there, his first flight. Okay, now what happens? Then he has become young seagull. As you can see here, young seagull. This bird has become young, and that's why it was the time to fly for this bird. That's why what happened? The family member, the parents of young seagull, they have learned how to fly by different ways, but he was not able to fly. That's why there were the two brothers, as I wrote here. That there were two brother and a little sister. They have learned how to fly by emulating their parents. It means by watching the activities of their parents, they were able to fly. And then what happens? Then it was the time for young seagull also, that the time had come when he must learn how to fly, because he has become young. That's why it was his duty to fly. When he tried to fly in the air, he became afraid. Then he tried his best to fly for so many times. But what happens? The idea came in his mind again and again that when he will try to fly, then definitely he will fall down. And as then he tried to fly in the air, he became afraid. And he thought that he would fall into the sea, because he was spending the life, we can say that all the family member were living on the ledge of a hill, and that's why he thought that he would fall in the sea as he will try to fly. And his parents threatened him, because the young seagull was not flying. At last, all the family member became angry, and they said that, they threatened him that, what was the threat? That he would stop on the ledge. It means all the family members said to him that we shall not provide you the food, and you have to stop. And that's why more tension increased for the young seagull. And his friends, parents tried many tricks to teach him how to fly. Not only one way, not only two, second way, not only third way. Instead of it, with the help of many ways, they tried their best to teach him how to fly. And at last, what happens? His mother had an idea. And what was done by the young seagull mother? She tempts him with food in her beak. It means, as you can see that, suppose this is the hill, and on the hill this is the ledge, and young seagull was sitting here, and his mother was standing here, and she came so near, and there was the food in the beak of his mother, and she tried to show that food, and there was the tempting of the young seagull, and that's why she tempts him with food in her beak. And now what happens? He comes to the edge of the rock and falls from it. Now he as he saw the food, he goes, and at last what happens? He falls from the rock. And when he opens his wings, when he fall down, when he was going to fall down, then he opens his wings and starts flying. This was the story of his first flight. Now we are going to read the lesson one by one. As I told you sometime before, the story of the young seagull, this is an imaginary story. The story conveys the message that one learns by taking courage and not by sitting idle. A young seagull is fed lovingly by his parents, but when the time comes for him to fly, he feels afraid. His parents try many tricks to teach him to fly, but he is so afraid that he refuses to fly. At last, his mother hits upon a plan. She tempts him with food in her beak, but she only flies near his legs but does not land there. In order to get food, the hungry seagull comes to the edge of the rope and falls from it. At first, he is terrified, but then he opens his wings and starts flying. He is happy to know that he did not fall in the sea. In this way, the young seagull learns how to fly. In this way, the young seagull learns how to fly. This was the story which is explained by me, and now we are going to start the lesson. The young seagull was alone in his nest. The young seagull, as I told you, a seabird. The young seagull was alone. He was alone. Where? On his ledge. On his ledge. Ledge means a part of a rope that is jutting out. Yeah, you can see that a narrow horizontal self-protecting from a wall via a cliff. Then young seagull was living there. His two brother and his sister had already flown away the day before. It means one day before. As I told you that he had two brother and a little sister, and only one day before they had already flown away from that ledge. But now it was the responsibility of the young seagull that he has to fly also. He had been afraid to fly with them. He wanted to fly, but he was feeling fear, and that's why he had been afraid to fly with them. He was trying his best to fly with them, but as he was going near the corner of the ledge, you can see that, and as he looked down, he was feeling fear, and that's why somehow when he had taken a little run forward to the brink of the ledge and attempted to flap his wings, he became afraid. So many times he tried to open his wings, but as he opened his wings and go near the ledge, you can say the brink of the ledge. Brink means the corner of the ledge, yeah, edge of the ledge, and attempted to flap. Flap means to move, and he tried his best to move his wings, and he became afraid. He was feeling fear. The great expanse of sea stretched down beneath. The great expanse. Expanse means stretch. Yeah, you can say that. Size. The great size of sea stretched down beneath. It means as he looked outside, he saw that there was a huge sea. Yeah, you can say that everywhere there was the water, because it was the sea, and it was such a long way down, miles down. He felt certain that his wings would never support him. So he bent his head and ran away back to the little hole under the ledge where he slept at night. He tried, but at last he thought that definitely he has to go, because he had decided in his mind that he was not able to fly. That's why he went in the hole where he used to sleep during the night, where he slept at night. Even when each of his brother and his little sister, whose wings were far shorter than his own, his brother and sister have very short wings in the comparison of young seagull, but even then they ran to the brink, flapped their wings and flew away. He failed to gather courage. Courage means boldness. He failed to gather up boldness to take that plunge. एंड विच अपीयर टू हिम सो डेस्परेट व्हेन हिज ब्रदर एंड सिस्टर वर फ्लाइंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ हिज आईज ही वाज फुल ऑफ डिसअपॉइंटमेंट बिकॉज ही वाज नॉट एबल टू फ्लाई एंड एट दिस मोमेंट ही वाज फीलिंग जीरियस His father and mother had come around calling to him and his mother and father they were also flying near him and they were calling to him shrilly shrilly means in a sharp voice they called again and again please try to fly young seagull please try to fly and upbraiding him and upbraiding means they scold him they rebuke him also they threatened him also as I told you that his parents tried to many tricks to teach him how to fly and as well as she tempts him with food in her beak and as well as when he tried to fly in the air he became afraid and it means different ways were applied by their by his parents and they threatened to let him starve and they said that we shall not provide you the food if you will not fly on his legs unless he flew away but for the life of him he could not move he was not able to move because he thought that as he will start to fly then definitely he will fall down that was 24 hours ago since then nobody had come near him it means till 24 hours his there was not even a single family member who came near him because everybody wanted to show him that they are upbraiding him they are threatening him also and that's why that was 24 hours ago since then nobody had come near him the day before all day long she had watched his parents flying about with his brother and sister and perfecting them in the art of flight teaching them how to skim the waves and how to dive for a fish it means at this moment the young seagull was looking towards his parents what was seen by him he saw that his parents were teaching his brother and sister how to fly and how to dive how to catch the fish and how to cross the sea all these things were explained by his parents and now how to dive for fish he had in fact seen his older brother catch his first herring and devour it standing on a rope while his parents circled around raising a proud cackle his brother and sister and as well as his all the family member they were crying They were saying again and again, "Please come on, come on, come on!" And he was watching. What was seen by him? His brother catch his first herring. Herring means this is a sea fish. And he saw that they were they catch sea fish, herring, and devour and eat it. Standing on a rope while his parents circled around, raising a proud cackle. It means his parents were so happy. When they saw that the two brother and one sister were flying and were catching the bird and all the morning the whole family had walked about put on the big plateau midway from the opposite cliff taunting him taunting cliff means hill here cliff means hill and taunting means mocking they were mocking at him with his cowardice it means they were so surprised that the young seagull was not trying to fly because he was feeling fear and in this way they said that they made a plan and what was the plan which was made by them at last but he is so afraid that he refuses to fly at last his mother hits upon a plan and now his mother made a plan she tempts him with the food in her beak but she only flies near his legs but does not land there in order to get food the hungry seagull comes to the edge of the rock and falls from it now we shall discuss the next part tomorrow but today you have to write down the question and the answer and as well as the word meaning of this lesson. Have a good day. Thank you.